see, it's pretty flat, it's pretty barren, coming from the mountains where I came from. About an hour away from my home. And here's the first one for today. Cute little piece. Nice. Almost looks like a piece of coral. Well, that's pretty. Got some crystallization going on there. Take that one home and clean it up. That's a nice little one. That's starting to look more like a rose, looking down into it, like a rose flower. Yeah, nice. There's a nice little piece. That is pretty. Small but pretty. That's a nice one. That's the best one yet I found today. Since coming out here. I just found a meteorite. I'm really excited right now. But also at the same time, I'm trying to keep my critical thinking skills going, that it might not be a meteorite, but it certainly feels heavy, dense. It's got some density to it because of the weight I'm feeling in my hands. And I don't know, it could be a piece of magnetite. Instead of a meteorite, but I'll take it back home and give it the magnet test and find out, see if it's magnetic anyway. Here's today's finds. Start with the first one that we found. Got some bubbles going on there, obviously, but more of a milky appearance instead of clear all the way through like glass. This was a good size one. Would seem like it's half of a giant rose. Like if it came out, if you can imagine it coming out this way and the center being filled in, it would have been quite a large, nice piece. And this one was the piece that was captioned fair. So, and it is. It's a fairly good piece. Pretty thin, flat overall, but pretty good. Bigger one here. Some crystallization going on. Iron stain on it, and there's the agatization on the side there, the lines. Here's the biggest one here. Some crystallization going on in there. It doesn't sparkle as good as if it was in the sunlight. I think I'll cut this one in half and see if there's some agatization going on inside. It looks like it might be. So, at some point when I get a chance, I'll cut that in half on the diamond saw. And this was the only piece of fire agate I found today. Yeah. Nothing spectacular, but nice little piece. And these are the roses. This one's a nice, good size one. And that's really starting to look like a rose if you look down on it. And when I cleaned it, took it out of the bleach vat, there was another one on the other side. So, two for the price of one, huh? So it's really nice double piece there. But this one here, this example here is the best so far for me and for you to see, the audience to see, and for me to explain why it's called the chalcedony rose, I think anyway. Like you're looking down on a rose flower again. And here's a little bit of a flatter one. Not as good as the one I just shown, but interesting all the same. So my camera went dead when I was out there. Apologies for that. Here in my work shed, I can thank you for watching my channel and coming along with me today. That darn wind. The last three times I've gone out, it's just been wind, and it's been muffling out what I'm trying to say on the videos. Thank you for coming along with me again, and remember, when you're out there, try to be happy, healthy, and most of all safe, and I'll see you on the next rock hunt. Thanks again.